Hello, good day to you all. Today we will go through chapter 2 of candlestick charting. Last week we covered chapter 1. We learned how to draw a candle, spinning top, doji, umbrella lines, hammer, hanging man and engulfing pattern. Candle. A candle has a real body. A green candle opens to the lower end and closes at the higher end. The body indicates the range of that movement. The upper range and the lower range indicating by the shadows. It is known as upper shadow, it's known as lower shadow. A green candle is known as a bullish candle. A red candle is known as a bearish candle. A red candle open at the top and close at the lower level. Then we learned engulfing candle, the one candle which engulfs the other one. The body is smaller, the body is larger. Then we learned hanging man. Hanging man with zero or very small upper shadow which is forming in the upper trend. It indicates a bearish trend. Here you can see the hanging man after broken down and came down the market down. Then we learned hammer and doji. Doji is the real body is small. A gravestone doji, which will come on the next class. This class today will come. This another doji is a small body with a long legs. We learned about shaven head. Shaven head don't have a upper shadow, and shaven bottom do not have a lower shadow. We learned about spinning. These are spinning candles. They have a small body. These are the shaven heads, a shaven bottom. Don't have a upper shadow or lower shadow here. These are known as umbrella lines with a narrow body on the top and long leg. If this type of candle is formed on the after a rally, it is called as a hanging man, indicating the bearish trend. And if the candle forms after a downtrend, indicates a bullish trend. It's a reversal candle. Then we learned engulfing. This candle is engulfed by this one. The real body of this candle will be engulfing the real body of this candle. This is known as engulfing candle. This is another one, bearish engulfing. That means it engulfed the bullish candle. The body is engulfed by this one. These are the examples of doji. We already gone through. Today we will cover dark cloud cover, piercing pattern, morning star, evening star, doji stars, gravestone doji, dragonfly doji, shooting star, inverter hammer and harami. So let us go through dark cloud cover. Dark cloud cover indicates a top reversal. The first of the two candles with a long green body and the second candle opens above the prior session high. That means opened gap up. However, it closes deeply within the prior white body. White or green body is an uptrending market. The first session is with a strong green candle, next session will be gap up opening above the previous session side. Then the market drops and closes below the previous day's close. The deeper the penetration, the more likely is the top. 50% of the penetration is good enough. We'll have a look on the dark cloud cover candle. These are the dark cloud cover. You see this green body candle. The market opened here. The market was closed here on this particular day, and the market opened here. Then the market pulled down by the BS. Here the gap market made a gap up opening. Then market was pulled down here and closed here, engulfing the body of this candle. If you see, after that the market trend down, and this part will become upper shadow, will be become the resistance of the particular movement. This is another dark cloud cover. Here is the preceding candle. The close here, and next day the market opened up here, gapped up opened, then market pulled down here. Then next day again one more gap down, small gap. And this part will begin the resistance of the move. The market came down. This is dark cloud cover. It covering the entire body of the preceding candle. If the dark cloud cover is formed after a downtrend, the candle is called as a piercing pattern. The counterpart of the dark cloud cover is piercing pattern. Piercing pattern is formed by two candles during a falling market. The first candle will be red and the second candle will be green. Second gap candle opens below the first real body low, gap down, and push well into the first candle's up real body. The second candle opens with a gap down, however unable to sustain the pushback towards the first real body. Here the bears measure the market with the gap down opening, however lose their grip and exit their shorts and tend to be bias. We'll explain a little more on that one. There is a long downtrend here. Market tried to open, move up with a morning star, but couldn't sustain. Then here again, with a inverter hammer, a real small real body with a long leg. Here you see that market tried to go back, pull back. After where any pullback again here, that means bear became stronger here. But here in this case, the market opened here. In this case, the market opened here and pulled back all the way up, threatening the bears. Till this time, bears were strong. But here market was pulled back, the market opened, then bears pulled down, then bulls pulled the candle market up. This candle is known as a piercing candle. It pierced the real body of the preceding candle. Here what happens is the bears, they got scared of the big movement and they exited their shorts. We call it short covering. Then next day market gapped up again and market moved all the way up. So this candle became the support of the entire movement. The lower end of the candle became the support. This candle is called the piercing pattern, the piercing candle. Now we will deal with the stars. Stars are as we saw already, small bodied candle. The body, real body is small. Can be green or red, which gaps away from the real body of the preceding candle. It is not opening low or same position, it is gapping up for an uptrend and gapping down for a downtrend. The real body should not overlap the preceding candle. We'll go on example on that one. This is a morning star. Preceding day market closed here. Next day the market opened here with a gap. And maybe bears might have pulled the market down here, but bulls pulled the market all the way up here, up to the edge of the real body, end of the real body. Then market pulled back again down here and closed here. Here you can see the gap is important for this type of charts. And next day again gapped up, giving a good signal that bears lost their control. Bulls already took over here. If the star's real body is doji, it is called as a doji star. Doji star is a warning signal for the reversal of the trend. Doji means the real body is too small. That means bulls and bears are in equilibrium, neutral strength. So we can expect a change in the trend mostly. A star candle has four reversal patterns: morning star, evening star, doji stars, and shooting star. There are top four types of candles we will be reading. A morning star is we call a morning star as a Venus. Planet Venus is a morning star because it comes on the sky little earlier than the sunrise. It is not a star, but it shows like a star, shines like a star. So we call it a morning star. Indication that the sunrise is going to taken place, day is going to break. The same way on downwind, in a downtrend, a small real body candle with a positive closing, green candle, indicates an approach of a sunrise. Here an uptrend. Candle 1 has an extended real body, indicating the bears are in command. Here, this candle indicating bears in command, because this candle opened here, closed here, and this candle opened, a gapped up, opened. But BS took over control and pulled the market down all the way here and closed here. So this side BS are in strong control. Next day market gapped down again, gapped down, not up, gapped down. That means BS was strong here and pulled the market down here. But somehow the bulls tried to pull back and it took the control all the way it came. Bulls pulled the market up here, then came down and closed. So this is a bullish candle in sense. We call that a morning star. That means it is indicating a trend is going to change. That means the sun rays is going to take place. Darkness is going to get over. So next day if you see that price gapped up again. It's a big gap, not a small gap, big gap. And the price moved up. And this bottom became the lowest part of the candle, became the support for the morning star. The trend already reversed here. An evening star is a bearish counterpart of the morning star. to qualify for an evening star, the first should be a bullish green candle. Here, the first candle is a bullish green candle. Second should be a star with a small real body. This one, second star one, is a small real body. There should be a gap between first and second. From this candle to this candle, there is a gap. Gap means without a trade. Market closed here, next day opened up here, higher. And went up here and went down here and closed here with a small body. This is called an evening star. Third candle should be a red candle with a penetrate deep into the first body. The third candle is important for the confirmation of this trend. This candle alone is not enough to take action. So third candle you wait. Third candle is the body is large. And most of the time it gap down. Here it closed, it opened down. Then market moved down. It almost covered the first body, part of the body, about 50% or more it covered. So the evening star, the upper shadow works as a resistance. So this is the place you have to put the stop loss. From there you can see market down, moving down. So evening star is a reversal candle for an uptrend. Doji stars are the same as evening or morning star, but the real body is too small. Too small, you can't see. Very narrow. You see that body? Very narrow. You see, this is very small. This is a doji star. If you see that candle here, market had a downtrend here, and here it made a doji star. Doji stars are always a reversal candle. And next day, market opened up here, but market pulled back again here, but unable to cross this line, this bottom shadow. The lower shadow is intact. Then next day, see, market opened above this candle and market moved up. So this lower shadow became the support and you got all the full moments. This is a doji star on the uptrend. You see, it's a small gap here, opened with a small gap. Market tried to pull up but couldn't sustain, and BH brought the market down and closed almost on the same level with a narrow body. Here the decision is not confirmed. So bulls and bears are in equal strength. Here it's an indecision candle. But however, next day market opened down, gap down. Then further ways the market moved down. 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 candle down. And this top part became the resistance. This is known as a doji star. This is an example of evening doji star in an uptrend. First candle, a bullish candle, green color. Then market gapped up. Market pulled up here. Then pulled back again and closed here with a narrow body. Next day, market gapped down again. Market closed here, market gapped down. Then market moved down all the way. And this part will become the resistance. This is our evening doji stars. Next candle we are dealing with is gravestone doji. The name suggests gravestone means putting a stone on the grave. This is a shape. Upper shadow is a bit high and body is too small and almost on the open and close position, same position. Market opened here, moved up and pulled back again, closed here. Higher the price rejection candle, Gravestone Doji. Gravestone Doji has an upper, longer upper wick. This indicates the price opens at lower level, then pulls up and brings down the lower leg again. Opened here, moved up, then market was pulled back again and closed here. That means the bears are taking control. Bulls tried to take the market up, but bulls were strong, so they pulled the market down and closed with a small rail body. This indicates the rejection of higher prices of early session. When the market opens and closes at the lower of the day, Gravestone Doji is formed. After opening, the market rallies, however, bears pullback and market. So the next day is a confirmation, market gap down again. Then market moved down. This is the resistance area. You see that market didn't go up back again again. A good market, good profit they made. People could made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 candle profit. The bullish counterpart of the Gravestone Doji is the dragonfly. It's like a dragon about to fly. Market opened and closed high in the session. Long lower shadow indicates bears try to pull down. However, the market pulls back and closed near the opening level. You see the market was in downtrend. Here market opened, little gap up, but the bears pulled the market down. It came all the way here. And the bulls tried to take over and pull back and closed very close to the opening. So real body became very small, not a doji. Lower leg is large. This is a reversal candle after a downtrend. So if you see that market tried to moving up again, then market went up. Next candle is a shooting star, has a real body at the lower end of the range. This candle, if you see, like a shooting star. Market opened up here and went up and pulled back and closed. The candle should have formed after an uptrend. This is a top reversal candle where there should be a gap between the preceding candle. All the stars and doji need a gap. The gap is a real indication of the strength, but if the market cannot sustain on the gap and it is pulling back down, that means the market is weak. The opposite party is going to take control of the market. There should be a gap between the preceding candle. The upper shadow indicates the bulls are losing control. Shooting star indicating a bearish signal. From the picture we can see second candle is a evening star and third candle gap down from the preceding candle and broke the trend line. Second and third candles are the confirmation of the reversal of a trend. You see that? First candle was a shooting star. Here itself we can see the market was on showing a downtrend. The market was going on sideways here. If you put a trend line, it will be like this. Sorry. Well, right. Here the market was making a sideways movement. Then this candle opened here, tried to pull the market up. But the market was pulled down back again. This is a gravestone doji. You can see this is very near small body. But there is no confirmation. Next day market gapped up again. Market was closed here, then again opened here. Tried to pull back, but the bulls lost their control again and came back. The one candle, second candle, and third candle, here it is indicating the this candle is known as the evening star. This was also opened up, gapped up, opened, moved up, and closed low. So all these three stars are indicating the bulls are losing control. That is the shadow, upper shadow indicating. The next day, market gapped down. A small gap indeed. Market gapped down, but broken the trend line. This is known as a trend line. The trend line is broken. And since then, the market gapped down and moved down. This is a shooting star. And this is an evening star. This pattern is a clear indication that market lost the upper trend. Now we will come to inverter hammer. Inverter hammer is the same as of a shooting star, however, the candle is formed after a decline. Shooting star is formed after a rally uptrend, and inverter hammer is formed after a decline. This is an inverter hammer. Market move down here. This candle tried to pull back. This candle tried to pull back but failed to cross this line. Here the market gap down, moved down. Very small length it moved. The real body is small here. But the bulls pulled the market up all the way up here. Here it covered this candle and this candle. Two candles covered and went up there. However, BS managed to pull the market down again and close here. Here the indication is that the bulls were here strong. They tried to pull back, but the BS won. The winner was the BS. The tug of war was still going on. Next candle opened and moved positive. So bullish candle. So this is a confirmation. Third candle is a confirmation. The market started uptrend from here. This candle is called inverted hammer. The long shadow indicates the bulls have pulled the market up. This candle is bullish candle. However, we need confirmation after the next candle. From the chart, we could see the second candle gap down. However, pulled back with a long upper shadow. Gap down means BS was strong to open down, but bulls pulled the market up. That is indication of the upper long shadow. Third candle made a gap up opening and made a strong bullish movement, engulfing the first real body. Here the bulls have taken control of the market. Next candle we learn is Harami. Harami is a small body candle that is contained within a long black or white body. Harami is a terminology used in Japanese called baby. Very called the long black or white long body means a mother and baby. The harami should be within the body of the preceding one. In an uptrend, the candle is formed, it is indicates the trend is exhausting. Harami cross is the real body. It's a doji. This is called a harami cross. either in an uptrend or a downtrend. Here the market was coming down. Market opened up here and moved up here and closed down. This small real body. So this type of candle is a reversal signal. However, we need a confirmation for all the candles. So next day it gapped up. That's a real confirmation. And it began to support here. Then market moved up. This is known as a Harami cross. Actually, the body is little more. The body could be little more less smaller. The real body is a doji. And the body is within the body of this one. This is the mother, this is the baby. The body is small. And here this is the mother, this is the baby. The body is small. So this is called as a Harami cross. Either it can be on the downtrend or in the uptrend. Let us see what we have covered today. Today we covered dark cloud cover, Pearson pattern, morning star, evening star, doji stars, gravestone doji, dragonfly doji, shooting star, inverted hammer, Harami. This much candles we covered. Please go through all these candles, study thoroughly. These are all very, very important reversal candles. All these candles pattern we are covering is indicating the reversal side. So that will work as a support and resistance. So very important to know all these candles. Here we will conclude today's lesson, chapter 2. Try to familiarize the candles as much as possible. Collect maximum information from each candle. I hope all of you might have downloaded Netdania. It's good charting software. So you can practice all these candles there. So there are a lot of charts in that. Indian stocks, Indian index, global index, dollar index, WTO code. So all this having different patterns. So you can familiarize all the candles from those charts. Next chapter we will cover Tuesday's belt hold lines, upside gap, two cross, three black cross, three advancing white soldiers, three mountain top, three river bottom. All these are multiple candle patterns. Gaps, support and resistance. Our next class also equally important. In fact, all the classes are important on the technical side of candlestick. Find out more time to study candlesticks. Very important chapter. Because furthermore, when you go for technical analysis, we need all those candles to analyze. So what action we should take there. Hope all of you are enjoying my lesson. Please feel free to write any doubts or any comments. Ask your friends to subscribe on my channel. Though there are a lot of more classes coming through. I wish you all have a nice day and safe stay at home. Bye.